Tell me, would any of you in this room be able to sleep, be able to eat, be able to breathe, knowing that your sons and daughters are being subjected to such unthinkable horrors? Your actions today sends a clear message to the hostages underground, and I hope they can hear us. In the terror tunnels of Hamas, the international community simply choosing not to care. The decision represents a grave moral failure. Today's text, just like the one a month ago, sends a loud and a clear message to Hamas. Terrorism wins. Murder hundreds upon hundreds of Israelis, abduct my people to your terror tunnel. Fire rockets from your hospitals and schools, rape, mutilate, torture my people. The international community will turn a blind eye. This body has chosen to make changes to the text of the resolution last month, yet at the same time has chosen once again to remain silent on Hamas' use of hospitals, its use of the Palestinian people as human shields. Choose once again to ignore our hostages and their fate.
If we look for a solution, it's always possible. It's only the will that's required. And I'm a true believer, because of my own experience, that war doesn't bring solution, except more war, more hatred, more agony, more destruction. So let's choose peace and resolve this issue politically. But I think all of you have said the two-state solution and so on, and hope this war will end and move into a true solution. Struggling to speak because the situation is beyond words. The situation in Gaza has actually deteriorated since the EBI special session in December. By the way, yesterday and today we've been working on some serious crisis. We believe as WHO that ceasefire is long overdue. And as we have said many times, no one and nowhere is safe in Gaza. 70% of the dead are children and women. That alone is enough for a ceasefire. Because the bulk of the casualty, you know where it is. So I think this thing has to be taken seriously. And going forward, by the way, the number of deaths will increase not only due to injuries, but chronically ill people, for instance. The risk of epidemics is increasing and people will die because of that as well. And people are facing death or risk of death because of hunger and starvation and famine. If you add all that, I think it's not easy to understand how hellish the situation is. You have the injured, you have the chronically ill, there is the epidemic, there is the starvation, all this combined, many ill people, while the health service is on its knees. We have around 36 plus 4 hospitals, but only 16 hospitals are now partially functioning. Partial, when I say partial, it's not even partial, it doesn't mean half. Some of the hospitals are at the minimum, actually.